Hi everyone, welcome to my channel and you are listening to Subhash Chandran. In this video, we are going to discuss about piping valves used in process piping, and this is going to be a part 1, so I will be putting part 2, part 3 to share more information about the valves actually. So without wasting time, let's get into the video. Before getting into the subject, if you have not subscribed, I kindly request you to give me your subscription. So now let's get into the topic. See, what is valves? The importance of valves. There are three main importance of valves. See, valves are used to arrest or allow the flow in the piping, and it is used to control the flow, and the third important reason is that used to safeguard the piping actually. So let's see this with an exam with the type of valve, so that you will be able to understand how we are going to arrest, how we are going to control, and how we are going to safeguard the piping. So now let's get into the classifications. When it comes to classification, there are different types of classification. The first type of classification is based on the function of the valve, and the second type of classification is based on the end connections of the valve. There are flange end connections, socket end connection, butt well end connection, and the third classification is based on rating. Different ratings are there based on the different pressure ratings, and the fourth classification is for based on the special purpose. So there are some valves used for special purposes actually, and the fifth classification is based on the type of the body. The valve body has certain types, so based on which it is also classified actually. But we are not going to discuss about all these classifications. That's because that if you go based on these classifications, you will end up with too many valves. But in reality, if you go and check the process piping design, you will only see the six major types of valves are repeatedly used in the design. So instead of focusing on the rare types of valves used in the design actually, we should focus on the major types of valves which are repeatedly used in piping design. So I am going to take you through the six major types of valves. The first valve is a gate valve, and the second valve is a ball valve, and the third valve is a globe valve, and the fourth type of valve is a butterfly valve, and the fifth one is a check valve, and the sixth one is a relief valve. Let's start with the first valve, gate valve. So what is the purpose of the gate valve? Isolation. So gate valve is used to isolate the flow. Isolate the flow in the sense it is used to arrest and allow the flow. So this is the schematic, the section of the gate valve actually. So from here you'll be able to understand very clearly. This is a gate. This is known as a wedge actually. When the handle of the valve is rotated, the wedge goes up and it will allow the flow. And when the handle is rotated in the anti-clockwise direction, it comes down to arrest the flow. So this is the basic function of the gate valve. Now let's go to the second type of valve, which is a ball valve. See, ball valve is also used for isolation and also used for the same purpose actually. So ball valve looks like this, which will have a ball inside, and you can see a hole over here. When the handle is, when the lever is turned, the ball will face the other direction of the body so that it will arrest the flow. If the handle is turned again in the anti-clockwise direction, it will open up the flow. So this is the purpose of the, this is the function of the ball valve. Let's go to the third type of valve. Third type of valve is a globe valve. Globe valve is actually used for regulation purpose. It is used to control the flow. So control the flow means you will be able to manage the volume of the flow that is passing through the valve actually. So if you look at the picture that I've shown over here, you'll be able to understand very clearly. This is the entry of the flow and this is the exit of the flow. This is the gate where it passes through the wedge of the valve actually. So here the gate valve, the globe valve, has a full control of the flow. So based on the opening of the valve, and you will be able to allow the flow accordingly. So that is the major purpose of the globe valve. Let's go to the fourth type of valve. Fourth type of valve is the butterfly valve. So the very importance of the butterfly valve is it is used for both isolation and as well as regulation purpose. So you'll be able to arrest and as well as control the flow actually. This is the photo showing the butterfly valve. Butterfly valve looks like this, with a disc in between and a hand wheel actually. When you rotate the hand wheel, you are going to turn the disc, which will allow the flow, and as well as when you turn the hand wheel on the anti-clockwise direction, and you are going to arrest the flow. So this is the function of the butterfly valve. Now let's go to the fifth valve. Fifth valve is a type of valve you must have studied in your engineering, which is known as a check valve. Check valve is technically known as a non-return valve, which means that it will allow the flow only in one direction. It will not allow the flow in both the direction. Let's see the sectional view of the check valve. This is how the external body looks like. This is how the internal looks like basically. So check valve will have a disc over here, which means that it will only allow the flow in one direction. If the flow comes from the opposite direction, it will arrest the flow actually. So this is the major function of the check valve. Check valve is only used for the in a location where where only one direction of the flow to be allowed actually. Now let's go to the sixth type of valve. The sixth valve is the relief valve. Relief valve is actually known as a safety valve, which is going to safeguard the system. Safeguard the system means it is going to release the exceeding pressure in the piping system. This is how the relief valve looks like. It will have a spring over here actually. The spring will have a set pressure. If the pressure of the piping system exceeds the spring pressure, the spring will open up the valve and it will release the excess pressure. So this is the primary function of the relief valve actually. It is also known as pressure safety valve. So relief valve is going to safeguard your system by releasing the exceeding pressure in the piping system. So these are the six important valves that are primarily used in process piping. I am not saying that you should not read about the other valves, but I would kindly request you to focus on these six valves instead of focusing on other rarely used valves, because these are the important valves that a piping designer should know about it. So I believe that this video has given you a little more idea about the valves used in process piping. If you like this video, give me a like and also share with your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel to motivate me so that I'll be able to put more and more videos for you. So I'll meet you in another fantastic video. Until then, bye from Subhash Chandra.